Guys, welcome back to Dom's Tech Chat. So today we're going to be talking about, I know I always talk about on this page about how you get into help desk, but I wanted to talk about something a little bit different. I wanted to talk about getting out of help desk. So a lot of times you will hear people say help desk is how you get your entry level IT role. It's how you get your foot in the door. And I agree, getting into some type of support role is a great way to break into IT, to break into the industry, just because it tends to have a little bit of a lower barrier of entry. And a lot of times there's a lot of positions available. However, the thing that you want to be careful about with help desk or even support roles in general is just if you aren't careful, if you're at the wrong type of company and just little things like that, you can end up stuck in a help desk role for way longer than you anticipated. You need to go over some of the things that I have learned in my experience from just what I've seen from myself and from the people around me, and ways that you can get out of help desk and so that you don't get stuck. Okay, so first things first, I know we talk about getting out of help desk, but where do you go? And that can be one of the hardest parts of deciding what to do after help desk, because there's so many different paths you can take in IT, right? For the sake of this video, I'm not gonna go into every single career field that you can branch into. I'm gonna keep it kind of to like the main three that people tend to choose, and that tends to be either system administration, networking, or cybersecurity. You see these roles. Sometimes you're looking at the job postings and they're asking for 3 years of experience with servers, but you've been doing over the phone support for the last year, so it's not something that you have experience in. So what do you do? How do you get attention to for these type of roles when you have people applying who have years of experience with these type of things? So that's when we get into home labs. I recently had on a job interview, the interviewer tell me that he put more weight in home labs than certifications. A home lab, and this is something that I have struggled with, is that a lot of times people traditionally will buy servers, they will buy switches, and they will buy them at home to learn how to administrate them and to practice things like configuring a switch or installing software on a server or working on it remotely. These are expensive. This is enterprise level technology sometimes that people are buying for home just to practice. So not everybody has that type of budget. I know I don't. So I wanted to let you guys know that one of the alternatives that you can have, if you keep seeing people recommend to home lab, home lab, home lab, and that's just not a financially viable option for you right now, is to do work in the cloud. So for example, Microsoft Azure and Amazon Web Services, you can go on and you can make accounts and you can set up a virtual machine. You're only paying for that virtual machine for as long as you're running it. Once you're done, you delete the resource. So I was able to do that to spin up some Linux virtual machines when I wanted to lab a Linux, or if I wanted to work on configuring switches, instead of going out and buying a switch, I use Cisco Packet Tracer instead. So is it a perfect match, or are you going to get as much of that hands-on experience with just setting up cabling and things like that, doing it the virtual option? No. But is it a lot cheaper? Yes. And do you still get to do all the software practice? Absolutely. So if you're someone that is looking to figure out how you can start your home lab and you get a little bit flustered when you see the prices of the sum of the hardware that people purchase, go for the cloud. And if it's something that you guys are interested in, I can give you a tour kind of how labs that I have run in the cloud, or how you can set up your first Microsoft Azure or Amazon Web Services account so you can get started with labbing in the cloud, or even with Cisco Packet Tracer, I can give a video on how to get started with that. So basically what you do with these home labs is you set up problems, or you might be following a class that gives you sample problems or things that you want to set up or even break, and then figure out how to fix it. And once you are comfortable enough with these type of things, then you can start putting it on your resume. This is where LinkedIn comes in handy, and I talked about this in my other video in regards to getting LinkedIn set up, but LinkedIn, you can document your journey on there. So if you're in help desk and you're picking up new skills, document on there like, hey, I labbed today and I went on Linux and I set up two virtual machines and I made them talk to each other and I set up a load balancer so that if somebody went to this IP address, it switched between two virtual machines. Give a little breakdown, a little summary, brag a little bit about what you've been doing, geek out. These are the type of things that will pick up recruiters' attentions, hiring managers' attentions, future employees or future coworkers about, and they might look at this profile and be like, this is someone that would love to work with, and you might get a job just from that. So it never hurts to go on there and document. Take some time to pick up a certification, pick up an advanced certification. Again, this is going to change a little bit depending what path you want to take. So for example, if you're going for security, Security Plus is obviously one of the first certifications that you want to get, you want to knock out. If you have the Security Plus already, you might start looking towards the pen test certification or some of the more advanced certs so that you can stand out for those type of roles. If you're looking for networking, you want to get your Network Plus, your CCNA. Even if you aren't looking to specialize in networking, if you're looking at security or system administration, I would still suggest the CCNA. You kind of can't touch one without touching networking, so you might as well get the CCNA, cover that basis while you're at it. My goal would be to pick up at least one advanced certification while you're still at help desk. Again, same thing, it's all just to make your profile, your resume, add a little razzle dazzle onto it. Something that you can tell recruiters, like, oh, right off the bat, I am certified in this. It's just something that makes you stand out as a candidate. Unfortunately, when you are in your beginning stages of your career, so entry level IT and that first step after help desk, they are really competitive roles. So do everything that you can to stand out because it can be hard. Along with that, with standing out, when you are at your help desk job, and a lot of people, this can be a bit controversial, but try to not do the bare minimum. If there's an extra project, take on the project, even if it's something a little bit out of your scope, a little bit out of your job description, because that is where you're going to get experience on things outside of just the basic password resets, unlocking accounts, fixing Outlook, restarting someone's computer. It's where you get more something to, again, stand out in interviews, to add onto your resume as accomplishments. So if there's anything at your job that you can think of or that you can volunteer for as something special, something that differentiates you from just an everyday help desk technician, do it. And as you're doing these, I actually on my computer just keep a little file of anything extra that I've done at my job or anything that I would like to bring out in the future if I have a job interview, just so I don't forget. It sounds dumb, but when it comes to interview time, they want to know all of that. They want to know everything that shows that you go above and beyond. And again, it's competitive, so you want to stand out. So those are the type of things that you just want to keep track of. Summary of everything that you would want to do if you're trying to get out of help desk or in that first year of help desk when you are gearing up to move out is work on some certifications, work on home labbing, document what you are learning on LinkedIn, and also add people who might be in a position where they can help you, or even just fellow colleagues. You want to make sure that you are stepping up, doing extra projects, and documenting all of these so that you can leverage them in interviews one day. I cannot say enough, it helped me so much on my job search to finally get out of help desk, which is something that I will talk about soon in a video. So these are the things that you want to work on so that you can get up and get out and get into a more advanced role in IT or something that might even just challenge you a little bit more. Just remember to be patient. It takes time. It took me a little bit longer to get out of help desk than I thought I would, thanks to the pandemic. I hope anything in this video was helpful. I hope there were some helpful tips in here. I will be talking a bit more about some of the advanced certifications that I am pursuing on this channel. So if anything with the Azure Cloud certifications, Amazon Web Services, CCNA, any of that interests you, definitely subscribe, hit that like button. I will be posting weekly, getting back to that. Also, I will be posting some new videos on just like my career, how I moved out of help desk, my first role outside of help desk, and just a little bit of how I'm going to be adjusting to all that. Soon, and I'll see you guys next video.